Hello. I've had a couple of months away from machining to concentrate on an electronic project that I've been meaning to build for years, but just never got round to. I've a number of timer control lights in the house, and they need adjusting several times a year to compensate for the shortening and lengthening days. This is a pain because they're all different and I can never remember how to program them. There was always the option of using a photocell, but that didn't really suit my application. I remember being fascinated by a mechanical time switch my dad showed me about 35 years ago that was designed for exactly this. This isn't the actual one, but it's a similar vintage. Using a clever cam arrangement under the dial, it's able to track dawn and dusk times automatically. The longevity and reliability of these timers is the stuff of legend. They still make them, though the quartz controlled now. It's a really fantastic mechanism. My plan was to replicate the mechanical timer's functions electronically whilst giving me control over four separate lights. I got together a microcontroller, a real-time clock, an OLED display and a GPS. Then I started to figure out the basics of C++. I did a tiny bit of PIC programming about 20 years ago, but I haven't done anything since. The beauty of the Arduino is that it's so well supported for the beginner. I went from flashing a single LED to a finished project in a few weeks. I started off with a Nano, but soon ran out of pins and memory, so I transferred everything to a Mega. As this is a one-off project, there was little point in making a rod for my own back trying to optimise the code to fit into the cheaper device. The final project would use a MegaPro 2650, which is functionally the same, but has about a 50% smaller footprint. Bit by bit, I breadboarded everything out for testing. Then, once the code started to take shape, I transferred it to Stripboard. The actual mains control is handled by commercially available RF switch sockets. I incorporated the transmitter using reed relays across the existing control switches. The advantage to this is I can control several lamps in different rooms without running wires all over the place. To calculate sunrise and sunset times, you need to know where you are on the surface of the Earth. With the mechanical timer, latitude is pre-programmed by the cams into one of four zones of the UK. This is the 50 degree model, with 52, 54 and 56 also available. On the mechanical timer, the time of day is set simply by rotating the dial, and the time of year is set by advancing the little wheel underneath. On my electronic timer, both time and location are collected once during setup from a GPS receiver and then stored. I could have hard-coded the latitude and longitude, but I wanted to avoid having to reprogram anything once the project was finished, like if I were to move house for instance. The mechanical clock maintains its time by a spring that lasts for up to 30 hours. If you can't wait for it to self-wind, it has the option of winding with a screwdriver. In my version, the real-time clock contains a coin cell that should keep it ticking over for many months with no external power supplied. Once set, I don't expect to have to go through the setup again for quite some time, as the DS3231 clock should be accurate to within a couple of minutes a year. On the mechanical clock, the on and off times can be tweaked plus or minus 45 minutes by moving the relative position of the operating pin on the arm. This makes the contact with the switching lever earlier or later. On my electronic version, there is an adjustable window pot, common to all four channels, so that my lights can be made to come on up to 2 hours before sunset and stay on for up to 2 hours after sunrise. The mechanical timer has an override function to turn the output on or off early, and my version can do the same. The display shows OVR in this instance, and the function mode indicates the word manual. Internally, my timer uses UTC for its calculations, as the sun doesn't care about daylight savings. The display, on the other hand, shows UK local time, either Greenwich Mean Time in winter or British Summer Time. It automatically switches over, but as there's some debate about whether we'll continue to observe daylight saving, I've added the ability to set it manually one way or the other. The little M indicates manual mode and the A is automatic. Some of my lights are night lights and need to be on for the whole night, but others need to go off at bedtime. The mechanical timer manages this by moving the off pin from the variable dawn cam arm to the fixed midnight bridge slot. Unfortunately, if the actual off time is critical, the mechanical timer has to be adjusted when daylight savings come into effect. I added a function to have each channel stay on until dawn or go off at a fixed time of midnight via dip switches, and mine follows daylight saving automatically. As an aside, daylight saving may never have been applied to this particular Sangamo timer. This unusual yellow face model probably dates from somewhere between 1968 and 1971, when Harold Wilson's government decided to try sticking with British summertime throughout the year and calling it British Standard Time. Note BST on the dial. The mechanism's the same, but the face has a 1 hour offset with respect to the trigger pins. In a nutshell, operation goes like this. As the day wears on and the sun heads towards the horizon, the timer is steadily counting down. The screen shows sunset and sunrise times, as well as when the light will come on and off. In this example, the window is set to zero, so the on time is the same as sunset, and the off time is the same as sunrise. If we fast forward to the moment of sunset, you can see the current status and the next event times update. A software monostable is triggered, which activates the on button of the RF transmitter. The receiver switches, and on comes the light. The light stays on until dawn, or optionally midnight. The timer counts down, then triggers the RF transmitter off button, and then off goes the light. Each day, sunset and sunrise times change by a minute or two, and the controller keeps track of this. So far, it works really well. There are one or two holes in the code, like what happens if I were to move to the Arctic Circle where there are periods of no dawn or no dusk at all, but I'll cross that bridge if I ever come to it. Anyhow, what I've learnt with the microcontroller should come in handy for some other project ideas I have in the pipeline. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.